Hi everyone, my name is Justin Odisho, and in this Adobe Premiere Pro CC tutorial, I'm going to show you the basics of how to get started in Adobe Premiere. So just basics on how to open the program and simple video editing so you're more familiar with the program. So whenever you open Premiere, you should be introduced by this start screen, and this can show you all the recent files that you've created if you want to open old projects, or you can create new projects. So I'm going to create a new project, and that should give you option to give your new project a name and choose a location on where to save it. By default, Premiere will save them all in its Adobe Premiere Pro folder, which I just leave them there. However, if you want a specific place to save it, you could choose your own folder. I'm going to skip the rest of these settings for now. They're all not super important, but these are just the basics. You can name your file and choose a location for it to save. So when you press OK, then it'll actually open up your new blank document. However, there's nothing really here except the menu. So the first step to creating a video or video editing is getting your media ready. So that's your video clips and whatnot. So there's a couple ways that you can import media. You have the media browser and things like that. However, I just usually like to go over to a folder on my desktop, open up all the clips that I want, and then click and drag those into the media bin. So now you see I have three clips in my bin here, and then I can just click and drag the first clip over to the timeline and it'll create a timeline sequence. So when you're looking at the timeline, you want to see that it's split in the center here. So the things on the top are your video tracks. You see V1, V2, V3, and then on the bottom you have audio tracks. So A1, A2, A3. And you can see they're stacked outward symmetrically from the center. Additionally, if you take any track and you scroll up on it, you can get a larger view of it, a thumbnail will start to pop up. And the same thing with audio tracks, you can make them bigger so you can take a look at the audio waveform, which are the peaks and the low points of the actual audio in that clip. Also, you can see the timeline, just like any other timeline, you can zoom out to view everything or zoom into one specific portion. And what you have here is your scrubber, which is the playhead or where you're playing or editing. And when you press space on the keyboard, that'll play the clip. Anywhere that the playhead is at, you could see it in the project or program preview window here. And right now I have it set to fit. However, if you want to see it at 100%, this is what we're actually looking at if you want to see up close. But I just keep it set to fit the whole time when I'm editing. And you can click and adjust the size of any of these windows to your preference. Let's say I don't want the media bin to be that big and I want more room on the timeline, I can do that as well. When you click and highlight a clip, on the left-hand side, you should see an ability to switch between things like source, effect controls, lumetri scopes, and a whole bunch of different info about these clips. So when I click this and I highlight effect controls, then I can see the basic video effect controls for this clip, like the position of it, the scale of it, which is the size, how big or small, the rotation of it, and all of these different parameters that naturally come with a clip. If you press this reset button on the right-hand side, it'll reset any of these back to default. Additionally, if you look over on the right-hand side, you should see an effects tab, and this is another place with a whole bunch of different video effects. So if I open up this video effects folder, I get all these different folders with different effects on them. So for example, if I go to blur, I can choose something like directional blur and click and drag that onto the video clip, and I'll see it pop up in the effects control window, and I can now adjust the parameters of this new effect that I just dragged on. So I could increase the blur length and change the direction of it and things like that. So now I've applied a blur to the whole clip. If I want, I can also click and delete that effect. Another important tab you'll see is the lumetri color tab. Here's where you can do things like adjust the color, the temperature, the contrast, and if you head to the creative section here and click and open it up, you can add all different types of creative filters. These are all preset in, so if I click this arrow and then click on it, this will add some cinematic type of looks if you want. You can add faded film, or you can open up tools like curves and adjust the color of each color channel by hand to create your own color grading or cinematic looks. I have whole separate tutorials on that, so don't forget to just check out the rest of my channel for more in-depth on specific topics. But let's keep it back to basics. Let's ignore all these different effects that we can add on. This is just generally showing you where everything is, so now you know where things are on the right-hand side, the left-hand side, and kind of where to be looking when you're working. But let's add a couple clips together in our sequence. So what you see here is the default sequence that we created from this clip, movie 1684. However, you can always go to File, New, and you can add new sequences in your project. So if I add a new sequence, I can make it whatever dimension I want. So settings, I can keep it whatever size I want. Or if I wanted a specific size, I could type it in and then press OK. And now you'll see we have a new sequence. It'll also show up in the media bin. So if I take a title, so go to File, New, and create a title, this will open up the title editor, and let's type out my first video or something like that. There's all these tools specifically in the title editor, like the font and the size. If you go on the right-hand side, you can go to Title Actions and center it. But this will add that title to your media bin. So let's click and drag it out to our timeline and then zoom in and extend it. Now when I go back to movie 1684, I can click and highlight and move this set of clips over, and then I can click and drag entire other sequences that we built. So I can take sequence one and I can put it into this movie 1684 sequence, and then that's how you can build out a project from different sequences, or you could just build everything all in the same sequence. Usually that's just what I do. So we've got this title, we've got this first clip. Now when I want to add another clip, let's say I want to add the second clip, I can do that. And there's a few tools that you want to get familiar with on the timeline. So on the left-hand side here, you can see all these different tools. And the main ones that you want to get familiar with are the selection tool and the razor tool. So the razor tool is pretty much like the cut tool. I can use that to create cuts. So let's say I don't want some of this clip, I can cut it out and then press V or click here and highlight the selection tool. I would get familiar with the shortcuts if I was you. V and C will switch between cut and move. And then I can click things, delete them or move them around if I wanted to, and edit together your videos by cutting and moving and sequencing things together. Let's say I wanted to add a transition in between these two clips. I could do that simply by right-clicking and applying a default transition. That'll give us a cross-dissolve. So that's a cross-dissolve. If I click on the cross-dissolve, I can choose in the effects controls panel to center it at the cut or start it at the end of the cut and things like that. So I'll usually center it at the cut. You could do the same thing with audio. And that'll just give us a basic cross-dissolve transition. You can find other different types of transitions in the effects controls panel under video transitions, or build out your own by combining a bunch of different layers. So you can edit videos by just continuing to add media on there, cutting things or chopping things, and then moving things around and arranging and sequencing your clips how you like on your timeline. And you can utilize different sequences if you want to build out certain specific parts and then drag those into your project. Another very important part of editing is just knowing basics about keyframes. So if I click on this clip and I see that there's a stopwatch next to any and all of these different effects that I can apply. So if I add a stopwatch icon, that'll toggle animation and that'll give us this little diamond, which is a keyframe. So that means I added a key at 100 scale. And then if I move over like 5 or 10 frames and I add another key at 105 as the scale, and then I move over another 10 and I take it back to 100, what you'll see is that'll create a little animation. It starts at 100 on this keyframe, then it transitions slowly into 105, and then it goes back down to 100. So keyframes, you can use them to animate any type of effect parameters or any effect controls. The possibilities are really endless creatively, but that's what that little stopwatch is, and that's how you can transition or start and stop effects, because you don't want something to just be rotated halfway during the clip and just play like that for the whole clip. Additionally, when you're talking about audio, you can adjust the overall sound or volume of the track right here. This is at 0 decibel or normal volume. And then you can lower it if you want. Let's say you're adding background music. You can lower it down to an amount that's suitable for your ear. There's no specific amount that background music should be at. You could just listen and use your ear to see how loud you want things like the background music or background noise to be. So once you're ready to export your project, let's say you've created it, it's your finished 10-second movie here with all your clips and your title, what you'll do is go to File, Export, Media. And this will open up this window to show you what you're exporting. So we're going to be exporting 0 to 11 seconds, and you can scrub through and see exactly what parts are captured. And there's a whole bunch of different ways you can export. If you just keep it at Match Source, which is the preset, it'll export things the same way that your original clip size was, which can work fine. Also, you can do things like go to the format, go to the preset, and there's all these different presets. So if you're exporting for YouTube, you can export for YouTube 1080p HD. It'll automatically take care of everything for you. And you could just choose an output name. So you could choose like My First Video. It'll tell you where you're saving it to, so the desktop in this case. And then just click Export, and it'll render and encode things out and give you an estimated time for it to finish. Once it reaches 100%, it'll go back to your editing screen. However, you should see your newly finished video on your desktop or wherever you saved it to. And then you can save your project and close it, and you should be able to open it up and edit again if you want. But those are the basics of how to do some simple video editing and some important things that you need to know, in my opinion, to get started with Premiere Pro. Definitely check out my channel and follow along for more specific in-depth videos on different subjects and topics, and subscribe to stay tuned for all types of new future videos. If you guys have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below or follow me on social media like Twitter and Instagram at Justin Odishow. I'll try to help you out. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.